Hello and welcome to this video. In this video, we are going to learn about verb tenses, the continuation of this lesson, 9.1 present tense. In the previous videos, we have seen verb and tense. Verb is a word which shows an action, state or position. Tense is the time of action shown by the verbs. It is the grammatical name of now, before now and after now, which means present tense, past tense and future tense. Present tense is the time that is going on. Past tense, the time that has gone or passed. Future tense is the time that is yet to come. Now, we will continue these topics and learn more about it. Look into your book. Take page number 49, 9.1. Page number 53, 9.2. Page number 56, 9.3. If you look into all these three pages, you can see the four aspects of tenses are written, which are common in all tenses. And they are simple or indefinite tense, continuous tense, perfect tense and perfect continuous tense. All these four aspects of these tenses go equally with the three tenses, that is present tense, past tense and future tense. Let us see how this works. See this table. If you see, horizontally some words are written and vertically, some words are written in both the sides, in the top and in one side. See, vertically, past tense, present tense and future tense is written, and horizontally on the top, simple, perfect, continuous and perfect continuous tenses are written over there. Now, let me tell you about all this. First of all, we will take the past. Past. The past is connected with past simple, past perfect, past continuous, past perfect continuous. It is similar with present tense, that is present simple, present perfect, present continuous, present perfect continuous. Again, with the future also same, future simple, future perfect, future continuous and future perfect continuous. That means all these four and these three tenses are connected with each other. That means if we are talking about past, then the sentence can be simple past, perfect past, past continuous or past perfect continuous. In any form, the past sentence can be written. It is same with present and future. If you are writing any sentence, in present tense, it can be a simple present, perfect present, present continuous, present perfect continuous. Similarly, with the future tense also, we can write the sentence in the future tense. It can be future simple, future perfect, future continuous, future perfect continuous. Now we will see all these by forming affirmative sentences, negative sentences and question form of sentences. We will start with a simple present tense. 9.1. Simple present tense. Simple present tense tells us about the action done in the present time. It also tells us about the habits, facts, general truth, simple actions. Habits, we know the things which we do regularly. It's a routine work, okay? So routine work means with the things which we do regularly. Facts, some true happenings. Sometimes these true happenings cannot be changed also. So these are the facts. General truth, the truth. Simple action, the simple work we are doing. So, all these things comes under simple present tense. Now, let us see the formation of sentences, affirmative sentences.
subject plus the first form of verb, and it is with s or es in some case that I will tell you, plus the object.
When the subject of the sentence is I, you, we or they, then the first form of the verb will come with this subject. And in case the subject is he, she, it, etc., then with the first form of verb, s or es is added.
And with the singular proper nouns also, when we are using subject plus verb 1 plus the singular proper nouns, then also we have to add s or es with the verb. Let us see some examples. I drink green tea in the evening. You write this poem. We eat together. They read newspaper in the morning. Now, what are the verbs here in the first sentence? Drink. Second sentence, write. Third sentence, eat. And the last sentence, read. See, all these verbs are in the first form, but no s or es is added with this. It is only because I, you, we and they. When we use the subject I, you, we, they, we have to write the first form of the verb without s. Now, see the other examples. He goes to sleep at 10 at night. She writes very nicely. It tells us about the ancient history. The sun rises in the east. Now, what are the verbs here? First sentence goes. Second sentence writes. Third sentence tells. And the last sentence rises. In all these verbs, we have added s or es. It is only because of the subject of the sentence. He goes. She writes. It tells. The sun rises. When we have he, she, it or a proper noun, singular proper noun, then the verbs, first form of the verbs will come with s or es. Now see these examples. I do not go out after 7. We do not watch TV serials. You do not sit there. They do not agree with the decision. What are the verbs here? Go, watch, sit, and agree. But before these verbs, we have added do not go, do not watch, do not sit, do not agree. That means this is a negative form, negative sentence. So whenever we are writing a negative sentence, we have to use do not before the verb if the subject is I, we, you or they. Now let us see these sentences. He does not go to office. She does not like this pen. It does not work. He, she, it is given in this sentence as a subject, and the main verbs are go, like, work. I have told you that when he, she, it is given in the sentence, when we are making the present, simple present tense, we have to use s or es with the first form of the verb. But when we are talking about a negative sentence, we have to use not and a helping verb before the main verb. So here we have used does. What is the spelling of does? D-O-E-S. We have added E-S to do. So when the subject is he, she, it, then the main verb will remain same and the helping verb will have E-S in its spelling and do will become does. That means he, she or it, the helping verb does will come if it is a negative sentence. Does not will come if it is a negative sentence. When we are making the questioning sentence or interrogative form of the sentences in simple present tense, Then do or does is placed in the beginning of the sentence. That means do or does is the starting word of the interrogative sentence. And when we have to use do? When it is I, we, you or they. And does is used with he, she, it. In this way, affirmative, negative and question, that is interrogative sentences, are formed in simple present tense. Now we will see continuous tense, present continuous tense. Present continuous tense is the action or the events that are happening in the present period of time. It can be also said as the action keeps going on at the moment. The word continuous. Continuous means it is a going on process, not ended. Okay. So when we are talking about the present continuous, means the action is going on at the present period of time. Now let us see how to form affirmative sentence in present continuous tense. When we are talking about the continuous tense, means verb plus ing form is used. Ing form is used in the continuous tenses. So sentence formation is subject plus be verb. Be verb is, when we write be as a verb, it will become am, is or are, plus verb's first form v1 with ing plus object. So in this way you have to use the words to construct a sentence. Subject plus am, is or are plus v1 ing plus object. Now we will see some examples. See these sentences. Three columns are made here. First column subject is written. Second column verb form of be. Then the third column the main verb drink plus ing and the object is written. Now when affirmative sentences are made, first we have to write the subject, then the helping verb, then the main verb plus ing and the object. Now see the second column, am, are, is. These words are the helping verbs. And these helping verbs are used with the subjects respectively, accordingly. Am is used with I. Are is used with you, we, they. And is used with he or she. Am, are, is. These words are used in the present tense. And the first form of verb with ing is used in the continuous tense. So when am, are, is plus verb ing is used, that means the sentence is present continuous tense. Now let us see some negative sentence, how to form negative sentence. The same sentences I have used here also, and here I have used apostrophes. Apostrophes are used when I have written am, are and is, that is with the helping verb. With, and what is the main verb here? Drinking. Before the main verb, word not is added, which is telling that the sentence is in the negative form. So to make a negative sentence, what we have to do is with the verb, main verb, before the main verb we have to add not, and rest of the things will remain the same. Am is used with I. Are is used with you, we, they, and is used with he or she. The verb form will be first verb form plus ing and the object. In this way, the negative sentences are formed. Now we will see question form or the interrogative form. In interrogative sentences, what we have to do is we have to shift the helping verb am, is, are to the beginning of the sentence, or we have to start the sentence, interrogative sentence, with the
helping verbs. And the sentence must end with a question mark. See these examples. Am I drinking water? Are you drinking water? Is he drinking water? Or is she drinking water? Are we drinking water? Are they drinking water? What is the first word in each sentence? The helping verb. The main verb will be the same. First form of the verb with ing. And the other things will remain the same. Am is used with I. Are is used with you, we, they. And is used with he or she. And the sentence ends with a question mark. So in this way, the interrogative continuous tense is formed. Sentence is formed. Now, the next we have to learn is perfect tense, present perfect tense, and also present perfect continuous tense, and the rest of the part also is left. I will continue these things in the next video. And till the next video, take care, be safe, and stay blessed. Thank you.